Good morning everyone, myself Bharat from DT Tech Solution. So today we are going to see the video shows about the radar emission masking using signal horned SA44B spectrum analyzer. Frequency covers 10 Hz to 4.4 GHz. So the software, which name is Spike, which is supported from a signal horned, the green icon shows the Spike software. So by clicking on this, so we can go entering into the Spike software. So this signal horn is an USB based, no need of any kind of external power supply. So this is the icon and is all the settings as per the spectrum analyzer setup. So start and stop, span value, and now we're showing in a full span mode from 100 kHz to 4.4 GHz. So now I'm limiting the band, frequency band, to 1 GHz to 1.1 GHz as per your requirements, that are around 1030 MHz to 1090 MHz, that your radar emission signal, once it's get enabled, we can able to, it will detect it. So I'm reducing the reference level. So now by reducing the reference level, you can able to subtract the spectrum. So now it's in a stable, so it's in the start 1 GHz to 1.1 GHz, I mean around. So here is RBW, BBW setting also, and some recording options also is available. You can record the signal also. So here is sweep trigger. So this is the main icon. So by clicking it, you can enter into the frequency mask trailer. So we are with respect to frequency mask only. So in case you need amplitude, you can go with amplitude. So frequency mask, in the sense, you can set a frequency from start and stop from a particular frequency, and you can set up with respect to that level. So I am just keeping it in minus 70 or some level. So it will set the limit line to 70. So once the signal is get enabling 70 AVO, it will detect it, and you can also import some CSV file also. You can save the CSV file also. For example, you enter the frequency and amplitude as per your band. You can also save it, the mask. So now I am setting minus 30 in 1 GHz, that means 100 MHz, and your starting position 1030 at minus 70 power level dBm, and I am adding the row. So I am set at level as 70 only. So now you can add the row. So now I am setting 1090, that is your maximum limit level. So as per your requirement, you ask from 1030 to 1090. So 70 and 1100, I am just changing to minus 30. So now you enable it, it will get the, say that you can see that green color from 30 to, you can see from 1 GHz 30, and from 130 is minus 70, and 190 also minus 70, and 1 GHz it's 30. So you can set it like that. Not only in this frequency range, you can set it whatever the frequency range, you can able to select it, and you can able to do it in the frequency mask from 4.4 GHz. So right now I am just generate one kind of signal, same as radar will emit some signal, same like I am generating one signal around your recorded frequency range. So I am using some tracking generator. I am just generating one tracking signal is a CW signal, carrier signal. So just I am, first of all, I am setting 1040 MHz. So 1040 MHz, so signal will now get extract. So I am using a spectrum analyzer with one receiving antenna. So the antenna received, and the signal is now in 1040 MHz. So it's showing in a red mark. So this indicate that your frequency, now your frequency is getting generated. For example, your radar is getting emissioning in this 1040. So the Spike software is highlighting that in a red mark. So I am just now doing to 1 GHz. So you can see it in a green position, in the sense there is no signal in within your band limit. So now I am setting in 1090 megahertz. So now you can see the red mark. So this is why once your radar emits some EMI noise or EMI frequencies in this particular band, your signal will be get enabled and your spike software will highlight it in a red mark position. So you can also hide the software, hide the control panel like this, you can able to view it. So once you keep like this, once the signal is get enabling, it will show us in a red mark. Once the signal is get disabled, it will show us in a green mark. So now I'm just show the control panel, and now I'm generating 1 gigahertz in the sense. So you can see now this signal 90 will be get disabled. It will, no, I mean, just setting in 1050 gigahertz. So it's still showing in this, and marker option is also available. So now I'm setting in 1 gigahertz, 900 or 900 megahertz. Now it's the signal is shifted to 900, so your signal is in the green position. So likewise, so here you can drag it also, you can also hide the setup also. So this is the full control panel. You can just keep it like this with any thing, and you can also save it the CSV file also, masking file. And you can also, once again, once you open the software, you need to once again, no need to go for a manual setup. You can just load your CSV file once again back mean, the line will be drawn as it is. So this is what which explain which is more suitable, spike software and the signal hunt SFO4B will be more suitable. So up to 4.4 gigahertz, you can set a limit as per your requirements with your, and you can able to load. And thank you for your video. We will see it in another one good video. Thank you.